So in this video, I'll be telling you why I only shoot 4K videos with my Nikon Z50, and I'm gonna talk about why you should actually film only all your videos in 4K, why should you only film in 1080p, and what's gonna happen in the future for video. So stay tuned. And if you stick all the way till the end, I'm gonna do an actual cool little 4K 1080p test where you guys are gonna get involved. I'm gonna show you, is this a 4K video or is this a 1080p? And if you can't tell the difference, then it kind of defeats the whole purpose of this video, but stay till the end for that test, but I'm gonna get straight into it. If you don't know who I am yet, what up? My name is Peter. I am a video creator for influencers, entrepreneurs, and businesses. So the straight lowdown of shooting 4K video is, what is 4K video actually? It is the actually image or video size. Think of, you have different picture sizes, it's the same thing and equivalent to video. So 4K video is actually 3840 by 2160. So it's not actually 4000, but they just round it off. Yeah. Just like in the comparison where 1080p is 1920 by 1080. And one of the big difference is that you can fit four 1080p screens within a 4K video. And as you can see, the difference from that is, one is image and video quality, two is noise and contrast and sharpness, and third is, because of the ability that you have to zoom in and punch in, you can actually downscale your videos to 1080p and have them 4K, so they all have an overall better looking video. So when it comes to my own videos, especially if it's clientele and I'm getting paid money for my videos, I like to give my clients the best quality possible. So that is going to be 4K video. And why would you want to shoot in 4K? Like I said, the biggest tip or pro is, if you downscale your videos or you render them out to 1080p, that means you can actually zoom into your videos, you can reframe. So for example, if this was a 1080, I'm filming right now in 4K on 24 frames per second, but let's say somehow, you know, the framing was off and I'm way over here, I can just punch in and reframe, so then I become the center again. And that is the benefit of, let's say you're filming something and it's like, it gives you options, right? And everyone likes options. And the whole benefit of shooting 4K is, it allows you to completely reposition your frame, so you can have completely a different shot when it comes to going super wide or super close without having to lose image quality. And on the same notion of this is that you can do the same with 1080p, but the only thing is, when you're zooming in, you're actually losing your resolution and the quality of the image if you zoom in. But I'm gonna talk about, you know, why the times that I only shoot 1080p. So the only times I actually shoot 1080p footage is when my camera doesn't allow so. So that means when I'm shooting in slow motion, this camera does not have 60 frames in 4K. Meaning that if I wanted to shoot anything in slow motion, whether it's 120 frames, 60 frames, then I would have to shoot in 1080p, not 4K. And when I do have to shoot in 1080p, I'm already in the mindset knowing that, yes, the quality isn't going to be as sharp, is not going to be that great, but I do risk that benefit or that disadvantage and that weakness for some cinematic, more slow motion videos. And those are the reasons why I suggest that you shoot 4K videos. But now I'm going to talk about why you shouldn't shoot 4K, who's 4K footage actually for, and who isn't. So one of the cons of using 4K videos and why you shouldn't be using 4K video is, you have to consider, do you have the equipment to handle 4K video footage? Just because, you know, 4K video is, yes, it's higher quality, but what that means, you're gonna have a bigger file size. So do you have the right SD card? Do you have the right computer, whether that's a MacBook or PC? You have to have some pretty high specs to be able to render and edit 4K video footage, as you going through the timeline and scrubbing is gonna be a lot more difficult compared to 1080p footage. As well as, how are you gonna transfer these files? Let's say if you were a remote video editor and you have client work, are you gonna send them a 4K video file, all the raw files? You know how big that is? That you're looking at like a 60 gig Google Drive or Dropbox, whatever your platform is, to transfer files in comparison to a 1080p footage. Also, another thing to consider why you shouldn't use 4K video is if you're having it for mobile or online social media platforms. Even yes, YouTube does support 4K, it is not fully true 4K video because there is compression and things like saving bandwidth. So as you know that if I upload a 4K video onto YouTube, yes, it does say 4K, but the quality itself is not the same quality that I render out of my Adobe Premiere. So take that in mind. Do you have the bandwidth? Do you have the laptop capabilities and specs? And more importantly, do you have that storage, right? 4K video, to store that and have that on your computer, that's a lot of space and memory. So do you have an external drive to back that up and store it, as well as having the actual power within your computer to actually edit, right? It's all cool when you actually go and film 4K videos, but once you edit them, do you have the powerful equipment to render that? Let alone the more higher resolution you go. I've had 8K video from a client put this on my laptop, and my laptop was not having it. But now you guys know the actual difference between 1080p and 4K, right? You're looking at a bigger video size as well as better quality. So in this part of the test, I'm going to show you and record right now two different blind tests. I'm going to tell you which screen, which side, and you guys figure out, you know, is the left screen or the right screen 4K? Is it 1080p? Which is which? So you guys let me know in the comments. That was my stomach. Right now I am recording. And can you tell which one is which? What if I flip it around and I move the right screen over the right screen? And if you're wondering, both videos are going to be on the exact same profile settings, as well as, you know, there's no same flat picture profile. So, and I'm also going to be able to crop and nest it, so the video actual sizes looks like the exact same. So which is your best bet? Which one is 4K and which one is 1080p? Have you commented down below yet? I'm waiting for you. And that, guys, was my 4K 1080p test. Did you guys get it right or did you guys get it wrong? Let me know. So for the rest of this video, it's actually be recorded in 1080p, so you guys can get the actual difference from the beginning of the video, which was shot in 4K, which is the end. Shoddy's like a melody. 1080p. So let you guys know, you know, what you think. And do you shoot 4K videos or do you shoot 1080p? And my overall thoughts and consensus of 4K video is it's only going to be the future. Within 10 years, everything is going to be 4K, right? You got 4K monitors now, 4K editing machines. And just like how I remember back in the day, I'm feeling a little old, but remember when YouTube had 480p? I'm like, wow, man, 480p is so crystal sharp. Wow, they have 720. But now looking back, I'm like, that is like a potato. And it's going to be the same thing with 1080p. 1080p is going to be 720, and 4K is going to be the 1080p of the future decade, if that makes sense. But as time and technology goes on, it takes some time to adjust for innovation, right? Your phones have the ability to shoot in 4K videos now, as well as be able to view 4K videos. And once that becomes the norm, 1080p is going to be not necessarily extinct, but is going to be the poor man's version of video. But that is not yet overall standard. You have things like TikTok, Instagram videos where there's not really 4K video because one, they have to host the bandwidth, as well as having the ability to upload those videos. They're just the safer bet for the overall news experience, and loading the videos is better at 1080p. But I can foreseeable future see that 4K video is going to be here to stay. And I remember when it was just dabbling around where it wasn't even an option on YouTube, but now it is, as well as YouTube even supports 4K going on, you know, 5, 6, and 8K videos soon to be. And like I said, that was my overall 4K 1080p test with my, if you're wondering, I shot everything in 4K 24 and 1080p 24 frames per second with the same exact settings, no auto ISO, 1/50, 3.5 with the kit lens at 200 ISO. And if you want to grab all my resources and check out and get 14 days off free off of Skillshare so you can get all my resources, check that out from me to you. And if you want to get really serious, I'm talking about like really serious, about using your camera, even if you have a entry-level DSLR, check out my camera mastery guide where I can help you. And I'm literally there with you, walking through hand by hand. I'm holding your hand 1 hour, showing you how you film better looking videos and content. And I break down my entire setup. So check that out. My name is Peter. You're watching A Broke Visionary Collective, where we all start with nothing, but you can always create something. Cheers, guys.